Well, let's talk about, yes, Obamacare. It is back in the spotlight. A new report claims that the GOP will suffer at the polls for not fulfilling their promise to end former President Obama's signature law. Obamacare rates are set to rise an average of 15% next year, resulting in more than $100 per household. So what do Republicans need to do to revive their effort to repeal and replace? Joining me now to debate is New York City Councilman Joe Borelli and former U.S. Ambassador Dr. Susan Johnson Cook. Thank you both for joining us this morning. We really appreciate it.
Thank you for having us.
So, Joe, I will start with you. I mean, is this going to be a problem for Republicans?
Well, short answer, yes. I mean, the 2017 individual mandate repeal was essentially the death knell of Obamacare, and now the figurative ball is in the GOP's court. You know, this is the issue that won them four successive elections. It brought them the take back of the House, the Senate, the White House, and they just don't have it in their arsenal this year unless they come forward with a plan. The good news is that the House GOP 2019 budget did assume a repeal and replace would be implemented, and we have some bills in the works now that are basically more broader repeals than we've ever seen, bills that are favored by conservatives, and ones that are modeled after the Clinton era and the Gingrich era reforms of welfare.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, Susan, what do you think? If it's going to work against Republicans, will it work for Democrats?
I think very much so. I mean, he talked about the good news. The bad news is that you have Republicans leaving the party. You have a lot of GOP people either retiring or just leaving. The second piece is that, you know, a lot of people have been helped by Obamacare. We are the country that had no care for our people, and so many people have been helped. So the double digits are not going to be something that deter us, but it's going to be something that helps us go forward.
Well, let's
so that's the good news on this side.
All right. Well, let's take a look at some of those raises in premiums. The average health premiums by the year, and you can compare, back in 2013, $232, jump ahead to 2017, $476. So, Joe, what do you think? I mean, that obviously is a double-digit increase.
Yeah, it's about 15%,
yeah.
And I don't think Susan is entirely wrong. You know, this is essentially Republicans taking ownership, and there is going to be a small increase right before the midterms this year. So if Republicans don't get their act together, if they don't get themselves lined up behind whether it's this new Health Care Choice Act, or whether it's something else, they are going to take a little bit of a hit. A new NBC poll out just said one in five Americans feels that health care is the most important issue going into the next election. So they have no choice at this point. I'm just concerned that they're not terribly good at self-imposed deadlines. Think the DACA fix.
Yeah, I mean, that's actually a good point. Susan, jump off from that point.
Well, I'm glad that he said that I'm not totally wrong, because I am correct. I think the other effect is, if it doesn't go double digits, people would have not had health care. So people are not concerned about it rising. They're making sure that every household has health care, and that this is what has happened with Obamacare.
Yeah, they also have a little extra money in their pocket, though, due to the tax changes under President Obama or President Trump's administration.
They do, but, you know, the bottom line is that every household in America should have health care. Every individual should have health care. And the good news is that they do with Obamacare. So whether the digits go up or down, it's, you know, households are covered. And I think that's what's most important for people.
Joe,
States of America.
Joe, it is an example of one example of Republicans not getting the work done that they said that they would get done.
Yeah, I mean, you know, they don't want to go into this year's midterms or 2020 with the last effort to repeal Obamacare dying because the Senate couldn't get enough votes. You know, recall McCain's 11th hour flip. They have to put something together going forward. Like I said, the 2019 budget they want to pass relies on pretty much a number of major cuts. It relies on an Obamacare repeal and replace. You know, there is no choice at this point. Obamacare has been a godsend politically for Republicans for 8 years, but now the ball is in our court.
All right, Susan, final word.
They haven't been able to replace or repeal, so this is something that needs to stand. Stop fighting what good things happened under Obama, and let's go forward as a nation and help our people.
All right. Thank you both for joining us. We really appreciate your insight this morning. Thank you.
Thank you.
Have a great day.
Thank you for having us.